Hi, I'm Dr. Wordperson, and today we're going to talk about the International Phonetic Alphabet and consonants. Much like I said in my earlier episode on the IPA and vowels, linguists use the International Phonetic Alphabet because it allows us to consistently transcribe all the sounds in the world's languages. Today, I'm going to teach you what all the symbols mean and how you, yes, you, can pronounce them. So now, how do we read this thing? Well, the columns represent where in your mouth you pronounce those sounds, going from front to back. Bilabial consonants use the lips, b, and labiodental consonants use the lips plus the teeth, v. Moving further back, dental consonants involve the teeth, th. Alveolar consonants involve the bony ridge behind the back of the teeth, s. And postalveolar consonants involve the space behind the bony ridge behind the back of the teeth, sh. The next two categories involve the hard palate. Retroflex consonants you make by flipping your tongue over and touching the bottom of your tongue to your hard palate, k. And palatal consonants you just make contact with your hard palate with your tongue flat, ch. Further back, you have velar consonants, which involve your soft palate, g, and uvular consonants, which involve that big dangly blob at the back of your throat, g. Finally, we come to consonants made way back in the back of your mouth. Pharyngeal consonants are consonants made with your throat tube or your pharynx, h. And glottal consonants are consonants you make with your vocal folds, uh. Now, on to the rows. The rows represent manners of articulation, in other words, what you are doing to the air to produce that particular sound. Let's go down the alveolar column because it's got everything. Plosives! These consonants block the flow of air entirely. For an alveolar plosive, your tongue goes up to the alveolar ridge and seals it off so that no air can get through. Duh. Nasal, same as a plosive, but you drop your velum so that air can go out your nose. Nuh. For reference, this is your velum and this is your nasal cavity. For trills, it's like a plosive, but your tongue rapidly seals and unseals, producing a trilling sound. I can't actually produce trills. Sorry. Go listen to Spanish. For a tap or flap, your tongue makes a single very brief touch to the area in question, a duh. You can actually hear the difference in length between a tap and a stop consonant, a duh versus a duh. Fricative, you hold your tongue or lips or whatever close enough to an obstruction that it creates a turbulent airflow and white noise, s. Lateral fricative, it's like a regular fricative, but instead of letting air go down the center of your mouth, you block the center and let air go out the sides. Sh. Approximant. Again, you're constricting the flow of air, but not so much you get turbulent airflow. R. Lateral approximant. Want to guess? It's like a regular approximant, except you block the flow of air in the center and let the air go out the sides. L. If you'll notice, sometimes you'll see two symbols right next to each other or in the same box. This indicates a difference between voiced and voiceless consonants, that is, whether vibrating vocal cords are involved in the production of that sound. Put your fingers on your voice box and give it a try. You can feel your vocal cords vibrate when you pronounce voice sounds, the, but not voiceless ones, s. Now, what's going on with the rest of the chart? This box contains non-pulmonic consonants, that is, consonants you don't make by pumping air out of your lungs. This includes things like clicks, la, and ejectives, k. Then we get two consonants that didn't really fit well into the above chart. Highlights include things like the voiced labiovelar approximant, as in Will Wheaton, and the voiceless labiovelar fricative, as in Will Wheaton. And this diacritic chart down here has some stuff that pertains to consonants. Here you find things like aspiration, t, and unreleased stops, ut. So anyway, I understand that this tour of the IPA consonant chart has been a whirlwind brain dump, but I hope, at the very least, that you can appreciate the simplicity of the arrangement. Don't know how to produce a particular consonant sound? Well, find it on the chart, put your tongue in that configuration, and then blow air through it in the right way. Or you can always turn to the handy-dandy clickable IPA chart online that plays the pronunciation of every symbol. Link in the doobly-doo below. So now you know the IPA's handy system for representing every consonant sound in every single human language. Now go forth and use your newfound powers to make sounds with your mouth. All right, That was the show. Thanks for watching. Did you know you can support me on Patreon now and read extra fun content that I put up? And maybe even get your name in the credits, like James Campbell here. Thank you, James Campbell. Yeah, like and subscribe, follow me on Twitter, tell your friends. Yeah, have a great time. Bye-bye.